Welcome to the Chamber Connection Show. I'm Mary Hodson, your host and president of the Chamber of Commerce here in Hutchinson, Minnesota. And I am really excited today to introduce to you Cassandra Kerrigan. Woo! The crowd goes wild. Tell me your actual title, because I'll screw it up otherwise.
Sure. I am the Veteran Service Officer for McLeod County.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. Welcome. We're glad that you're here. Thank you for taking time, because I know that you and your staff have a lot of irons in the fire and you're helping a lot of people. But I also think it's really important to be able to get this message out to people who are veterans or no veterans, Absolutely. No matter the age. So we kind of talked about that, right? So let's just jump in. Who's utilizing county veteran services, or who can?
We have a whole wide age range. It could be somebody in their early 20s just coming out of the service. It could be all the way up to somebody in their 80s, 90s. I had a 101-year-old in my office not too long ago.
Wow.
Anybody who's ever served in the military, anybody who's ever put on that uniform, that's what we're here for. Help them navigate their benefits, federal, state, local. Educate them on what they are eligible for and help them apply for those benefits.
So they don't have to have seen you before or even realize that there's services and someone to navigate with them.
Right.
They can call you up or show up and say, I need help?
Absolutely. Yep.
Okay.
So we do recommend an appointment so that we can dedicate our time to them. But right. If they just walk in our office, if we can see them immediately, we will. If not, we'll schedule an appointment.
Okay.
But no, they don't have to have ever been to our office. They just have to have served in the military at some point in their life.
Even the Navy?
Even the Navy.
Look at that. Did you see what I did there? For some of you, you're going to get that. Even the Marines?
Even the Marines.
Wow. Okay.
There's a Space Force now, too, just so you know. Even the Space Force. We'll see them, the Coast Guard.
Wow. I joke because my husband was in the Navy, and there was always, everybody has a little bit of a little joke, underlying joke, about whether you were in the Navy, the Army, the Marines, the Coast, I mean, right? They all have a little thing going on.
We can tease each other, but if somebody who's never served in the military teases us, then it's like brother and sister. We'll
Ooh,
have your back,
okay,
and we'll fight for you.
Note to self.
Don't mess with us. We'll protect each other.
Okay. And National Guard.
Absolutely.
Yep. Okay. All right. So let's just dive in. What are some of the services that you actually can help a veteran with?
Yeah. So there is a large variety of benefits, whether it's the federal government. We do VA disability claims, whether a veteran was injured in the military or they were exposed to a toxic or had an illness while they're in the military. Those are all under that VA service-connected disability. We help them navigate that and help them fight for that benefit. There's the VA medical centers. A lot of times people think that's the only benefit that veterans have is the VA medical center. That's not true. There's education benefits, home loan guarantees, death and burial benefits. There's other financial assistance programs through the federal government.
Okay.
Now, the federal government does have their own definition of what a veteran is. The state has their own definition of what a veteran is. Our local organizations have their own definition of what a veteran is. Anybody who's ever served in the military, I'm always going to call every single one of those people a veteran. Whether you qualify for all the benefits is another thing. And that's what we're here for, is to help you determine which benefits you're eligible for.
So you might be having a conversation with somebody who served during this time, and they're eligible for one thing but not another, just depending mm-hmm. on who they are, where they served, when they served.
Yep.
Is that kind of right?
That's absolutely correct.
Okay.
Yep. And we look at their discharge document to help them figure that out.
Okay.
And they don't have to have that in their possession to do that. That's one of the other services we offer. Hey, I served in the military, but I don't have documentation of it. Cool. We'll help you figure that out. There's places that we can go and request records through, okay. whether that's the National Personnel Records Center or the VA has some of those records. If they're guard or reservist, there's different entities that we can request those records for...
So not everybody protects those discharge papers like they're told to.
Weird, no. Most important document of your whole military career, and some people just don't have it. And it's okay. Like, some people that lost it in a house fire or multiple moves later, you know, years and years
multiple
later.
Multiple homes and all the files get intermingled. And
yep.
I will say that is the one file in our house that I know exactly where it is my husband's discharge papers.
Well, good.
Well, he was a yeoman also. So let's clarify that, right? So yeomans are all about the administrative.
Admin stuff, yep.
Yeah, okay. All right. So what you also said that there's local support. So what does that look like?
Yep. So here in McLeod County, we have a financial assistance program specifically for veterans who live here in this county. It's the assistance fund that we have access to is the McLeod County Veterans Association Assistance Fund. And that association is all of our American Legions throughout the county.
Okay.
Our VFWs, the DAV, they came together and they created this association to help local veterans. It started off with our VAN program, which is another local program I'll talk about here in a bit. But the financial assistance, if a veteran comes to us and needs help with a bill, if it's under $1,000, we can take care of it locally here.
Okay.
And we don't have to go to the state or the federal government or some nonprofit organization to help with that. We can take care of it locally.
Okay.
Now, this transportation program that I talked about. So our office runs a transportation program also. We pick up veterans at their homes, take them to their VA scheduled appointments, whether that's the VAs themselves, St. Cloud, Minneapolis, Shakopee, or the VA community care appointments. The VA's doing a lot of more referring out into the community for appointments that they can't necessarily do in a timely basis themselves, or they just don't have that specialty themselves. And we'll transport veterans to those appointments too.
I did not know that you had that program.
Yeah.
Because the DAV also.
Absolutely. So our programs kind of complement each other. We can only go to VA scheduled appointments.
Okay.
If a veteran calls us and it's not a VA scheduled appointment or the VA is not paying for that appointment, then we refer them back to the DAV.
Okay.
So I have 10 drivers on my payroll that helps them transport. I have 5 vehicles. I've got 4 regular passenger vehicles and 1 handicap accessible vehicle.
Wow. Okay.
And then the DAV has a whole slew of vehicles and volunteer drivers that can take veterans and their spouses to medical appointments too.
Okay.
So we refer each other to the other program if we can't satisfy that need.
Okay. Well, and I think that's one of the beautiful things about the veteran support that we have locally. You and I were just at a gathering at DAV for the anniversary of the Vietnam Veteran War conflict, whatever we call it now appropriately, the end of that. So it always amazes me when you gather a bunch of veterans together and to see the support. And just like you're talking about, it's very collaborative.
Mm-hmm. We all have the same goal. We all have the goal to support those who put on the uniform.
Yeah.
The end.
Now, in the news, many of us have been hearing about suicide rates and mental health in general and for veterans. What do we have here that can help veterans when they're dealing with mental health or mental health crises?
We have a lot of great mental health resources, whether it's through the federal government or even local entities like Lutheran Social Services provides counseling services. National number 988. Easy number to remember.
It's like 911, but it's 988.
Yes.
And it's an emergency line for mental health for anyone.
For mental crisis, yep. Veterans who call that number, just select number one when they go through. And it's 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. Anything on there is confidential. So, mental health has been this stigma in our country for such a long time. But it's finally coming up that, you know, we all have it to some capacity and it's okay to ask for help. It takes a strong person to ask for help.
Yes, it actually does that strength, I think, is what people think of it as the weakness, but it's really that strength. Mm-hmm. You talked very eloquently, and I'm not going to do it as well as you did, but you thanked Vietnam veterans for going before you. Mm-hmm. You have served. Thank you very much. But you thanked them for what they had to go through so you could come home to a supportive community.
Yeah. Our Vietnam veterans were treated like crap when they came home.
Yeah.
They were sworn at. They were spit at. Our community disgraced their service.
Yeah.
And it was that era of veterans that said, never again will we allow generations after us to come home to that same crap.
Yeah. It's heartbreaking to think about that because mm-hmm. my experiences personally have all been very positive. Thank you for your service. Thank you for your service. Thank you for your service. People who recognize them at meetings, at restaurants. There's veteran parking at certain retail stores, right?
It's becoming more common now.
It is becoming more common. And I think that for me, having come from a background of service, my family before I met Kevin, right? My dad, his dad, himself. I just have this level of pride for that. So to think about how Vietnam vets were treated is really heart-wrenching mm-hmm. to think about that. But then they said, okay, we're not going to let this happen again. Mm-hmm. When they could have said, you know, fine, be yeah. that way.
Yeah.
But they dealt with a lot of emotional trauma that was not cared for during mm-hmm. that time as well. So we've learned.
Yep. Post-traumatic stress disorder was not a thing then.
Yeah.
Shell shock. I mean, it's had a whole lot of different names.
Right. I think that, and correct me if I'm wrong or you have a different thought process, but I think that as people went through COVID and kind of had their own internal war, if you will, right? Not the same, but that's when people really realized, oh, I'm having some mental issues right now. My brain is not balanced like it used to be. And that kind of opened up Pandora's box for us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
How do you think that veterans manage that now when something like COVID comes or they're redeployed? How do you think they're dealing with that these days?
I think that we're giving them the tools, or at least making it more known, the tools
right.
to deal with those things. We have a great community that supports veterans. So mental health awareness is all over the place for veterans.
Yeah.
I don't see that necessarily in the general community as much,
right.
but it's all the same resources. We mirror each other.
Yeah.
You know, 988 is for everybody, like you said.
Right.
It's not just for veterans.
No. But, of course, we know, most of us know the statistics about veterans versus the general public, mm-hmm. right? I think that's where it has been exacerbated mm-hmm. in the past. Let's go back and talk about some of those services now. If somebody comes in and they have just come out of the service and they've been there for, what, 3 to 6 years possibly, maybe even more, and now they're like, reentry can be very difficult.
Mm-hmm.
Talk about that process, would you?
Yeah, so we will first sit down with a new veteran, freshly coming out of the service, or even just a couple of years removed from the service, and let them know what federal, state, and local benefits exist out there. There are resources within the, deed.
Okay.
That yep. works with veterans to help them translate their military transcript into civilian terms. There's higher education representatives assigned to every single okay. college in Minnesota that can help them navigate their education benefits. I know you probably have talked to Tim Burley before.
Yep.
he's got a welcomehome.vet initiative yes. to help welcome them back into the community. It's easy to be in the military and have somebody tell you exactly what to do day in and day out, provide that housing, provide, you know, all of those, your food every day.
This is when you're going to go eat. This is what you're going to eat.
Yes.
This is when you're going to get up. This is where you're going to go.
Yep. Yep. So having somebody coming straight off of active duty service and not necessarily having to do everything on their own, depending on how long they were in the military, some of those transitions can be tough.
Yeah.
And that's where there's a lot of resources to gap that military to civilian life transition.
I think that we're very, very fortunate because I've talked to other communities and they don't all have the same support mechanisms that work together.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that that's what makes us so strong, is that we're able to do that networking, the collaboration.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so someone, maybe they're in the hospital, their spouse says, don't you have any benefits or something that can help us with this situation? They're going to call you. What's that look like?
Actually, this is a quite common phone call we get, whether it's a hospital or it's an elderly veteran needing to go into assisted living or long-term care, and that the family's making that first connection. There are health resources that we can get them into, whether that's the VA Medical Center, or long-term care resources. The state of Minnesota has 8 veteran homes run by the state of Minnesota. 3 of those were just opened up this year.
Okay.
So there's options for veterans for long-term care. There's also options to help pay for that or help reimburse that if a veteran served during a wartime period.
Okay.
So again, we go back to that discharge document. We look at what their military service was.
Okay.
If the veteran can't navigate that themselves, if the family will work with the family and collect all the documentation that we need for whatever program best suits their criteria.
Because I suppose you do get the spousal calls or maybe children of a veteran that call and say, you know, someone said once that there's support and my parent needs some support. Mm-hmm. So you're helping everyone in the family navigate.
Yeah. Sometimes we get a phone call saying, hey, I was told I need to apply for aid in attendance. Aid in attendance is not a benefit in itself. It's a part of a benefit.
Okay. What is aid in attendance?
Aid in attendance is a level of benefit. So you have your service-connected disabilities. If the veteran service-connected disability is why they need nursing home care, aid in attendance is that a little bump up on that service-connected disability.
Okay.
That's one part. The other part is non-service-connected disabilities. When a veteran needs to go into a nursing home and they serve during a wartime period, they don't have to serve in the war, they just had to serve during that time frame. We call that veteran's pension. There's 3 tiers to that veteran's pension. The bottom tier, they're living independently. They don't need help with really anything. Second tier, we call housebound. Could be assisted living. They need some minor help with things.
Okay.
The third tier, we call aid in attendance. That's nursing home care.
Okay.
So we're applying for that benefit if a veteran is needing help paying for that bill or reimbursing a part of that bill if they're low income, low asset. And I say low asset, $155,000 is what the VA deems low asset for that benefit. A whole lot different than Health and Human Services medical assistant benefit.
Right.
So,
wow. I'm just thinking here as I'm listening to you going, wow, and we owe veterans so much. I mean, they went and fought for our freedom. You went and fought for my freedom. Thank you again. I know that somebody's going to call and ask, so let's just ask you, what did you do in the service? I mean, give us a little bit of your background.
Sure. I have served just over 20 years in the Minnesota Army National Guard.
Wow.
Officially retired end of March, so it's days old.
Right.
I served 14 years as an enlisted soldier. During that time frame, I did 2 tours in Iraq, and then I went through officer candidate school and commissioned, served my last little over 6 years as an officer in the Medical Service Corps, did a 3rd deployment to Kuwait in 2021.
Right. So. And you have a family.
I have a family, yep.
Yeah, it's mind-boggling to me. I have a really, really good friend who is a military spouse, and the things that I've learned from her over the years about what our families go through is astounding. Do you want to talk a little bit, too, about the Yellow Ribbon?
Sure.
County, that we're a Yellow Ribbon County.
Yeah, so we are designated Beyond the Yellow Ribbon County, and every time somebody talks about the Beyond the Yellow Ribbon, it may be a city, it may be a county. Here we are a county entity. Mm-hmm. We are not a nonprofit organization, or they are not. I'm not really necessarily involved a whole lot anymore, but they are not a nonprofit organization because we have the Veterans Association that helps with financial stuff. But what our McLeod County Beyond the Yellow Ribbon does do is they recognize seniors who are entering the military. We give them a little flag, or they give them a little flag pin to put on their graduation gown. And then we also welcome home anybody who's coming off of active duty during the county fair. So we invite their family out to a free day at the fair when we had to pay for the fair. Also the grandstand event on Sunday, recognizing them. The local businesses donate to a welcome home gift bag that we present to each of those individuals who came home in the last year. So those are the two big initiatives that our local Beyond the Yellow Ribbon does, which I think is pretty big.
Yeah.
Thank the people going into the service, thank the people coming back from the service.
So I don't know if you saw or if you watched, but we were watching some state basketball because there was a blizzard, right? I mean, everybody was in the house. And so they did, I don't know, it looked like they might have had 100 kids there, kids, probably seniors in high school, taking the oath right there on, in between games.
Oh, cool.
They were taking the oath, and I thought that that was so cool. See, I'm just getting goosebumps about it right now. I thought it was so cool to recognize that, because sometimes we forget to recognize kids who aren't going off to play the big sport at college or, you know, going to medical school, when in fact we need kids to be going off into all these different things, including the military.
Absolutely.
So I thought that was a great way to showcase them in that instance. And I believe they were all going into the National Guard. So that's cool.
That is.
Okay. So we have just a couple minutes left. What are your steps or your suggestions to somebody who's hearing this from the first time, or maybe they know somebody that they want to share this information with them, you know, whether it's across the fence, or maybe they have a loved one, or maybe it's themselves and they've not really heard about any of the things that we've talked about? What would you suggest to them?
I would recommend contact our office. Sit down with one of our service officers. It's myself and two assistant service officers. Any one of us can explain the benefits. And I don't care if you served active duty, you served in the reserve, you served in the National Guard. I say sit down with one of us, let us go over your service records and explain exactly what you're eligible for.
Right. Because you might not need it right now.
You might not.
But it's sure nice to know later down the road.
Absolutely. I'd rather you make an educated decision on benefits farther down the road than rush through something, especially when it comes to death and burial benefits.
Right.
Your family should be grieving at that time, not trying to figure out your benefits at that time.
Right.
So no question is a dumb question. We will answer any of those questions, help you navigate it. And if you want to apply for stuff, that's what we're here for. We will fill out all that tedious paperwork that the government requires. We will help you determine which documents we need. We will help you package it all up with a pretty little bow and send it off to wherever we need to send it to. We do majority of the work. We just need you to do a small percentage.
So do you know how many veterans are in our county?
That is always a good question.
Because they're not all registered with you, right?
They're not all registered
with
us.
And some move and come in.
Yep. So the state of Minnesota and the federal government goes off of what benefits are being applied for.
Okay.
Last statistic I saw was 2,200. But again, that's only people who've ever applied for benefits. So I would say well over 2,500
oh, for
here
sure.
in McLeod County.
Yeah. Well, and it's probably nice to know for parents too, if their child, their student, their young person is thinking about going into the military, to know that there are support systems in place for when they come back. Mm-hmm. And it's a great life option.
It is. Minnesota is a proud state to welcome our veterans home. We've got a lot of great things here in Minnesota. McLeod County, we welcome you back too. I would like to say we're a proud county.
Yeah.
We've got a lot of great support from our county leadership for all of the programs that we offer. So
yeah. And if you're a business that wants to support Beyond the Yellow Ribbon, you can also connect. And there's signage, if you have not seen, there are stickers and signs that say that I am a Beyond the Yellow Ribbon supporter or a veteran-owned business. So if you're looking for those things, we can connect you as well.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for making the time to come in today. I really appreciate it. And if you have more questions about how to get a hold of Cassandra, a quick phone number.
Sure. 320-864-1268.
And if you didn't catch that, you can always call us at the chamber office at 320-587-5252. We'll get you connected. Thank you so much for joining us today. I hope that you have a great month. And don't forget to share this information with others that you might know in our community. We're always trying to reach a broader audience, and you can help us do that. Thanks so much, and we'll see you next month.